Simon, it is awesome to have you here today with us.
Thank you so much. Good to be with you.
I'm a fan of your material and your books, and your training is just amazing.
It's brilliant.
It's brilliant. And so tell us, tell us a little bit kind of the journey of me as far as your training all over the world.
Sure, sure. So I left Disney 15 years ago, cashed in my entire 401k with significant Disney stock, took out a line of credit on the house, and turned down 4 job offers to go and work for other companies because I answered 3 questions. What would I do if I knew I couldn't fail? What would I do if no one paid me to do it? What makes me come alive? And when I answered that 3rd question, I said, I want to speak, write, train, consult, and coach if no one paid me to do it. So literally, for 15 years, we worked with almost 1,500 organizations in 45 countries, teaching men and women how to live brilliantly, lead differently, and grow profitably.
Beautiful. Wow. And that's your book you just came out with, Brilliant Living, 31 Insights to Creating an Awesome Life. I think everyone wants to be awesome and have awesome.
Absolutely. Well, it really starts with understanding average is over, average is done, average is history. So you might as well be brilliant while you are here for the rest of your life.
Absolutely. Yes.
So what I recognize is that in a very busy world that we're in, how can I begin to teach people insights that I've learned from companies and top performers from all over the world in 2 minutes or less? And give them an application and affirmation that they can use over 31 days. So that's how it's set up.
Great. 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Can you give us one of those?
Yeah. Sure, absolutely. So one of the things that I teach is transformation is 1 inch from your nose. If you think about it, a caterpillar, when it becomes a butterfly, it lives in what it spits out of its mouth. So when you begin to understand that, we have to upgrade our verbal software and recognize that words carry energy and words create worlds.
Yes,
so how do we transform our world while understanding transformation is 1 inch from our nose? Begin to speak where we're going, not where we've been.
I like verbal software. That's a new term for me. That's good.
But yeah, we have a problem though.
Yes, sir.
What if we don't know how to speak? That's where you come in, right?
Absolutely.
Tell us about how to speak. How should we speak?
So first of all, I would encourage everyone listening to us to write down on a piece of paper in 30 seconds or less what's right about you. Because sometimes we focus on what's wrong with us, and that is the story that we tell ourselves, and that's the story that comes out of our mouth. So something happened, we make up a story, and we give speech to it. When you write down what's right about you, now you begin to speak where you're going and who you're becoming by speaking in the right way.
Good.
Oh, that's cool.
Excellent. I think that's in the Word of God, isn't it?
It is!
It's a principle.
Who knew?
Yeah, exactly.
You copied that out of the Word of God.
Yeah. So what kind of stories have you seen as far as transformation of people's lives when they apply these principles, what they speak about themselves to others, how they see themselves, what they say?
One of the emails we received from a mother, she said that she is a bonus mother. She has a stepdaughter that she's trying to build a relationship with. And she began to read the first step of creating an awesome life on Dare to Be Brilliant. And her stepdaughter said, well, how do I dare to be brilliant? What does that mean? And she began to tell her about understanding your strengths in life. What makes you unique? Well, literally, they started a puzzle based on reading the book, and they went out to Shutterfly and asked Shutterfly to create puzzle pieces that spoke to the strengths of her 12-year-old daughter. She said Shutterfly sent her back a 225-piece puzzle that they put together. Now it lives on the wall of her 12-year-old stepdaughter, and she says, I know what my strengths are.
Wow.
I don't have to worry about being average. And when we read it, I was like, oh my goodness. So now we call it the strength puzzle. And we're going to share that story to encourage other parents to begin to help your teenagers understand school grades you on the average, but if you see yourself as brilliant, you exceed average scores.
Good.
Wow,
excellent.
That's awesome.
Excellent. As we think we are, right?
Absolutely.
And so when you start with kids and you start putting that in them at an early age, instead of speaking curses over their life, you're dumb, you can't do this, you never would, why would you think you could do that?
Yes.
Tell us the culture. I mean, how do most people live? I mean, tell us the problem. You know, how were we trained? How do people live life? And we know speaking's part of it,
sure,
but it starts up here.
Sure, absolutely.
Tell us what you've done a lot of studies, I know.
Sure.
So tell us what you see out there.
So Princeton Psychology Department says when the brain is worried about change, uncertainty, ambiguity, and volatility, the brain slows down. When the brain slows down because of worry, the brain doesn't create neurogenesis, which is the process of growing neurons, which grows the brain. Mm-hmm. So if the brain slows down because of worry, change, ambiguity, change has a best friend called stress, and stress has a first cousin called fear. And when stress, fear, and worry get on the same page, they slow down the operating system of a person who's made in the image of Christ and after his likeness. So when we find how to use the control alt delete button, which is who am I and whose am I, you begin to delete from the mind drive and the heart drive those things that cause worry, stress, and fear.
Oh, awesome. So take me in a step. I mean, tell me, let's say I don't have anything going for myself.
Sure.
Okay, you're coaching people how to live the awesome life.
Yes.
The brilliant.
I don't have a great job. I don't have really, I'd come inside, I don't have an education. I really have nothing going for myself. How am I going to live the brilliant life you're talking about?
First thing you have to start with is seeing your life as a puzzle. And whatever's happened to you is just a piece of the puzzle. So the first thing, I begin to examine, where have I been? And the where have I been question is, how did I get to this point? What have I learned? How have I grown? The second question is, why am I here? Now, the why am I here is not why did my mom meet my dad, but why are you here, right? Yeah. The third question is, what can I do? Because so many people focus on this has happened and I can't do anything about it. But the what can I do question becomes the bridge to where you want to go.
Yes.
And then the fourth question is the strategy or the plan, where am I going? Because some people plan their vacations better than they plan their lives.
That is true.
They just let life happen to them, and they feel like they're a victim of circumstances instead of taking control of them.
That is a good statement. Say it again about vacation.
So some people plan their vacations better than they plan their lives, and there's a lot of energy when it's time to go on vacation. But what about your life? My mentor, Tudor Bismarck, said to me a few years ago, he said, do you have a 20-year strategic life plan based on how you will grow spiritually, financially, wellness, socially? And I said, no. I said, why do I need a 20-year strategic life plan? He said, because in 20 years you're gonna be older, but will you be better? Huge opening, huge eye-opening experience. I said, you know what? I can be intentional about that. That's brilliant living. Not letting it happen, you being a part of the solution.
That's excellent. How does that impact people's businesses and their families?
One of the things we are hearing from businesses who really understand brilliant living is that they can shift from customer service to customer love. Customer love is going above and beyond for the customer, not because you have to, but because you want to. So it's not just doing more of the same, it's looking for that opportunity to surprise and delight. That's brilliant.
Do you want to end the war on sadness? Then click the button right there and subscribe.